Apache Spark has a library for different types of machine learning models. In this tutorial, we will talk about how to use Databricks to implement the Spark ML linear regression model. We will cover what's the difference between Spark MLlib and Spark ML, how to process the data to the right format, how to fit a Spark ML linear regression model, how to evaluate model performance, how to save the model, how to make predictions for new data. Let's get started. Firstly, let's talk about the difference between Spark MLlib and Spark ML. Spark.MLlib is the legacy machine learning API built on RDDs. Spark.ML is the new machine learning API based on DataFrame. The name MLlib includes both the RDD-based API and the DataFrame-based API. The RDD-based API is now in maintenance mode, so there will not be new features added to the RDD-based API. In this tutorial, we will use the DataFrame-based API, and I suggest you use it as well. In step 1, we will import the libraries. Pandas is for data processing. Make regression is for creating synthetic modeling datasets. From the pispark.ml library, we imported vector assembler for feature formatting, linear regression for model training, regression evaluator for model evaluation, pipeline, and pipeline model for pipeline creation and loading. In step 2, we will create a synthetic dataset for the linear regression model using make regression. A dataset with 1 million records is created. The dataset has two features: a bias of 2, one numeric dependence variable, and 30% noise. Random state ensures the randomly created dataset is reproducible. The random state does not have to be 42. It can be any number. The output of make regression is in array format. We convert it into a pandas data frame, then convert it into a Spark data frame. Summary gives us the summary statistics of the dataset. After creating the modeling dataset, in step 3, we will make the train test split. Using random split, we split the dataset into 80% training and 20% validation. Seed equals 42 makes the random split results reproducible. However, we need to make sure that the same cluster and partition number are used when reproducing the split. We got 800,299 in the training dataset and 199,701 in the testing dataset after the split. Linear regression expects a vector input as features. So in step 4, we will use vector assembler to transform the features into a vector format. We can see that in the newly created column called features, the two features are listed in vector format. In step 5, we will fit the linear regression model. Firstly, the feature column and the label column are specified for the linear regression. Then, the linear regression model is fit on the vectorized training dataset. After that, the model intercept and coefficients are printed. We can see that the model has an intercept of 2 and coefficients of 82.09 and 35.03 for the two features. Alternatively, we can create a pipeline and fit the model on the pipeline. A pipeline usually includes both the data processing steps and the model fitting step. If you find the video helpful so far, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. In step 6, we will evaluate the model performance using the testing dataset. In order to do model performance evaluation, we need to first make predictions on the testing dataset. Using the pipeline model created in the previous step, we can transform the testing dataset and make predictions with a single line of code. After having the predicted values, we pass the prediction column name and the actual value column name into regression evaluator. Metric name can be one of the following values. RMSE is the root mean squared error. RMSE is the default value for metric name. MSE is the mean squared error. R2 is the R square. ME is the mean absolute error. We can also create a scatter plot to visually check the relationship between the actual value and the predicted value. To learn how to use the built-in charts function in Databricks Notebook, please check my previous tutorial on Databricks Dashboard for big data. In step 7, we will save the pipeline model to a WS S3 bucket. To learn how to mount S3 bucket to Databricks, please check my previous tutorial Databricks mount to a WS S3 and import data. After saving the model to S3, we can confirm the model is in the bucket using the %ls command. We can see that both the pipeline stages and the metadata are saved for the model. In step 8, we will go over how to make predictions for new data using the saved model. We first create a new dataset with 1,000 records. The number of features, The bias and the noise are the same as the training dataset to ensure the new dataset follows the same distribution. Then the pipeline model is loaded from the S3 bucket, and the prediction is made on the new dataset. In this tutorial, we covered how to use Databricks to implement the Spark ML linear regression model. You have learned what's the difference between Spark MLlib and Spark ML, how to process the data to the right format, how to fit a Spark ML linear regression model, how to evaluate model performance, how to save the model, how to make predictions for new data. If you found the information in this tutorial helpful, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. I publish tutorials on machine learning, deep learning, and big data processing every week. If you prefer the written version of the tutorial, please go to grabandgoinfo.com. I will put the link in the video description. This is the blog post for this tutorial. It has all the code and explanations in the video. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.